All right, just test out the mic. Hold on. Hey, Steph. Be right back.
Getting the guide out. This is the kind of game that definitely needs a guide. I actually owned a Phantasy Star 3 guide back then. So here we go. Shape our lives and those of our children. One such legend is of a struggle that almost destroyed our world. The names of Arakio and Leia echo down through the years, still inspiring love and hatred even now, 1,000 years after their deaths. Their conflict wiped out civilization and left the survivors in a world of mutated creatures and warring pockets of men. Why is P capitalized? In a shattered world, you are thrust to live or die by... I didn't finish reading that. I guess we'll have to find out what we live and die by. Okay, so... just get the menu buttons down here. So you're Reese in the first part of this game. And this is the music that, if you listened to our most recent podcast, you heard this in our Town Themes mixtape. So, what are we doing? Everything seems fine. Talk to people, learn about the current situation, and then head to the castle, okay? Wait, what button am I using here? I gotta change the, button configuration. Yeah, so, Maya, washed up on the shore. I gotta change the button configuration. here we go. I want... Well, I want full screen. Oh, there we go. Okay, so, oh, okay. Wait. How do I... Okay, good enough. Yeah, so you're about to marry, Maya, and then you'll see some stuff happens. Yeah, we don't have any whatever the currency is. Jeez. Pressure me a little bit. Where you gotta go. Oh, there we are. You can't fast walk in this game, which is annoying. Oh yeah, you can! Oh, here we go. Hell yeah! Push your bride to the throne room. Except, how do I get into the throne room? I forget how you do this. I haven't played this game in a very long time. Oh, there she is. Our blue hair sort of matches. So, your kid's wife has been stolen away by demons that look like they're in Super Ghouls and Ghosts, So, what do? You toss your son in the dungeon. I like how it goes willingly, too. Yeah, you can run fast using the fast forward. Cool. I like in this game how they, when they pull up the dialogues, you see both people like this. It's cool. This is a great town theme. Gotta find the weapon shop. I think this is magic. Oh no, fortunes. And this is our, no sir, not a priest. Definitely not a priest. His items. Here we go. Ooh, thunder. Oh, I gotta sell first. Hold on. Very cool. I was just double checking the buttons to make sure they're all right. Yeah, that is one problem with the Sega games, because that was a three-button controller, it's an ABC. So when you play it on a modern controller, it's not really the most, for a lot of games, it's not super graceful. Head south to a town called Yada. Save. Try to gain at least one level on the way there.
Okay.
So we're gonna hit some random encounters at some point here. I assume that's Yada. Yeah, it is. The battles in this game are very obviously influenced by Dragon Quest and the way they're set up. There, talk to a man by the fountain to learn that you need a cyborg to be able to use his boat. Oh, Ren, yes. Oh, yeah, shout out to the fountain in Final Fantasy 1 that tells you that you should wash your face because it's so dirty. Yeah, so this game is a pretty medieval setup, unlike the first two Phantasy Star games that are very much sci-fi settings, except there are totally cyborgs. Head outside the town, walk east, and then cross the bridge. Oh yeah, I saw the bridge. Starting to take points off. They're chipping away at me. You know, this isn't Dragon's Dogma, where I can not carry heals around anymore. Oh, yeah, we'll stay at the end. With the pink-haired anime babe. I think in all honesty, a lot of my early interest in anime came from the fact that I was like, oh, it's like Phantasy Star. And also, in some ways, Castlevania. Crossing the bridge. Cross the bridge and go south to the town of Lon. Oh, right. Right there. Excellent. Oh! Staying in the inn didn't give me... didn't do my HP. Ooh, that's good to know. Alright, we gotta buy some cures. When we get here. Hey, does the game soundtrack sound a little scratchy on the stream? It's a little staticky in my earbuds. Not a lot. Okay.
Hi, Puzzle.
Puzzle, would you like to be on the stream? Come here. Oh, oh, Puzzle, you're fat, man. Say hi to everybody. You don't want to stay up? You're getting fat, dude. Doctor next month, they're gonna say, oh, Puzzle, you gotta go on a diet. They already did that a couple of years ago. His doctor was like, you know, you could lose a couple pounds. Outside. Yeah, so if suddenly the stream dies, it's because the power went out here. Oh, I know why it didn't, because I saved. I didn't... Right. Oh. Oh, that was my screw. I forget what. I've got to get down straight what each one is. Yeah, the soundtrack, it's a little crackly in my ear. No, it's saved. And then I didn't gain any HP back. And it's the armor guy. I screwed this up. Let me go fight a battle. I haven't really seriously played this game in a long time, so just bear with me here. No, it's not here. Alright, hold on. I gotta look this up.
I'm doing something wrong.
Okay. I know why. I got poisoned in one of the battles. But where? You have to go to the hospital. Hold on, Fossil. Oh, okay. Alright, I got it. It's because I'm poisoned. Puzzle, hold on. Alright, we gotta do a fight, and hopefully we survive. We can always go back to my last save. I'd forgotten that you could get poisoned like that. Yeah, the music sounds, it's like slightly scratchy. I think it's probably the emulation. Let's get a screen grab of that for, one of my favorite Twitter accounts, a video game advisor, which posts screen grabs of video games giving you advice. All right, now here we go. Okay, so. All right, so we gotta grind to level 3. These enemies aren't too tough, so. Actually, let's just make sure. Oh, I never went to the end. Shoot. Hold on. Oh, man, I'm doing this all wrong. Oh, and I only have 4. I think I gotta do one fight so I have enough, Meseta, or whatever the coin is. Gil. We'll call it Gil. Rupees. Every game is rupees from now on. Oh, shit. Come on. No! Oh, we can reload from the save. And we'll just have to avoid screwing up like that. Oh, yeah. See the P?
Right.
Okay. Yeah, definitely not a church with that music. No, sir. Oh, okay, I don't have enough, so I gotta go do a battle. Alright, this makes sense now. I haven't done a serious run through this game probably in, let's see, 2018. About 16 years. 2002, I want to say. Maybe it was 03. It might have been even 03. Alright, so let's get in a quick battle, and then we'll, we'll get going. Now we gotta get in one more fight to get enough to heal at the end. And then we'll be back on track. Yeah, I just kinda screwed this up at the beginning here. Oh, it's the other one. It's the one. There we go. All right. Okay. All right, we gotta grind to level 3. Oh, I got poisoned again. Shoot. I gotta buy some antidotes. And I gained the level. Oh, there we go. Thank you. Alright, let's grind to another level so then we can buy some cures and whatnot. It shouldn't take too long. Oh, we've been ambushed. Yeah, let's try to be one level ahead of the guide. Okay, Steph. What time is it? 7:53. I'll probably stream for a little while longer because I'm pretty sure Sarah's gonna stream tonight. So, I'll probably just stream until she does, and then everybody can go over to hers. I'll be around later. So, all right, talk to you then. Thanks for coming by. Ooh, we surprised them. And we gained a level. Excellent. hate that you have to buy them one at a time. The worst game with that was the first Final Fantasy. But shout out to the tip in Nintendo Power, or maybe it was GamePro, that you could use the NES Advantage to just keep buying them. You know, thankfully in modern games now you can just bulk buy. I'll never forget that in the first Final Fantasy game, the Nintendo Power Guide. I think it was the first cave of, I think it was one of the fiends at the Marsh Cave. No, not the Marsh Cave. The one, south of the town where, the scholar guy is. Who hangs out with the Luffians. That cave, I remember Nintendo Power saying that you needed 99 heal potions to go in. That was their suggestion. I remember just being like, what is in there? And what was in there was the source of much gnashing and screaming, as many times I would get through it, and then on the way back out, would end up dying. Okay, where are we going now? Head north past the bridge and west a little until you see Yada again. Okay. Yada. North and east between the mountains. Yeah, okay. Forest, follow east until you see a lake surrounded by a forest. She's poisoned again. Legs turned up by force, and a woman should be standing there. She won't be there unless you've talked to the townspeople. What townspeople? Oh, back in the town. Oh, crap. Okay, we gotta go back. Nah, I screwed this up. That's okay. It's not that far. We'll stop it at Yada on the way. As I was saying, it's been over 15 years since I played this game, so bear with me while I kind of get my bearings back. This is one of those games that I've often talked about in the podcast where there were games that just kind of took over my town and everyone played, and this was one of them. Doing a save, I'm hearing some thunder in the background here. Yeah, I hope, you know, I don't know if you can hear it on my mic, but there's a lot of thunder in the area right now. We're supposed to be getting a storm. Oh, and I got poisoned again! Oh, these enemies suck.
One second. Ow. Okay, that's a little better. I was trying to get out of the light in the background. Helpful thing in this game is that the villagers just kind of stand in place. They don't walk around like in Final Fantasy or get in your way. Alright, at least we're doing some, by having to go back, you know, we're doing some grinding, too, which is fine by me. Okay, that looks a little better. I gotta move my, one of my lamps. Yeah, I should probably put it side of the TV, like it was in my last apartment. Yeah, there's glare coming off of it. Actually, let's see what it looks like without it on. See if it looks too bad.
Oh, what if we put on the other one? that just brings back the glare.
I don't know. We'll figure it out. Oh wait, I didn't go the right way. I gotta go back. And I crossed the bridge. I'm learning. Wait, where am I? Oh, okay, we're right back to the first town. So if we go down... I don't know where I... Oh, come on! I'm lost. Damn it! Alright, so this is Yada. Oh, I wasn't lost, really. I'm north and east. Yeah, actually, I sort of was lost. I was less lost than I thought I was. I'll need to buy a couple more heals. And head east between the mountains. Oh, okay. Alright, I remember where we are now. Right, okay. I got it. Wow, you're back already. Hey. Hold on, I dropped my coaster. We are about to get our second party member. Whoa, crap. Oh, cool. Yeah, we'll definitely have to hype that up on the Twitter feed that you're doing that. That's really cool. Whoa, that enemy took off half my HP. Yeah, here she is. Wow. But I can still one-shot him. She's been waiting for 1,000 years for you. Except when we came here earlier, she wasn't here. So I think, on our podcast cover, I think it's the Miu joins you dialogue is our screenshot from this game. So, Miu's got the ribbon and the claw and the vest. Alright, where do we go now? Head back to Yada. That thing again. Mia's got the claw. gotta get her another weapon. This is one of the pieces of music I associate the most with the Genesis. Train until Miu is at level 4 and Reese is at 5 or 6. So Reese is at 6, Miu is only at 1. So, alright, let's get her up. Alright, we'll do the, we'll grind here for a little bit and then we'll wrap up for tonight. Because Sarah's probably going to stream pretty soon. Also the Doctor Who marathon, which is into the second Doctor, I think started today, I think. Because yesterday it was still first Doctor, but they were right at the end. Right when he regenerates. Oh, my controller battery getting low, too. At least these early battles are pretty easy. A thing that really was an advantage that Phantasy Star had over Final Fantasy as well, besides having the awesome PHAN, was that if you aimed at an enemy and they died previously, you would just hit the other enemy, which was something in the first Final Fantasy, I guess actually the first couple Final Fantasy games. If you aimed at an enemy and they died because somebody else killed them first, you would just miss, which was insufferable and very frustrating. And in, you know, later reissues, they, you know, they fixed that, of course. Achievement level 2. We'll get around the Final Fantasy at some point. I need to get a... I have the Origins version on my PS3, which I think is the best version of that game. Maybe the PSP one, too. But, I need a HDMI splitter for the PS3 because you can't just hook it up to the capture card. I mean, you can, but it doesn't... you don't get the best quality. So, I gotta get a splitter. Which I can probably get, you know, I can order them online if I really wanted to, but I could go to, like, Best Buy in, Morristown. I was actually in that lot, that Best Buy lot, last weekend. Because I went to Dick's. And I didn't even think to go over there. But with Splitter, then you can hook it up to your capture card, and then we can play some PS3. And all those PS1, those sweet, sweet PS1 RPGs. Suikoden, Breath of Fire 4. Final Fantasy. The Origins. You know, those, the PS1 reissues of those Final Fantasy games are... hit or miss, but the one of the reissue of Final Fantasy 1 on there is pretty good. And that's the up until the Game Boy Advance, it was the only version of Final Fantasy 5 that was in America. That was brand new to us when that came out in 2002, 2001. No, I mean, could have played it, you know, with emulator or an import, but most people have never played that game before. Alright, we got stopping it in. Gaining a lot of currency. What level is she at? 3. Okay, a little more. I hate that you have to double hit those menus. That's really annoying. They were talking about this collection, the Genesis collection, on Player One this week. And they were saying there's some issues, there's some lag input issues in some games. And that actually might explain a couple of issues I was having with Gunstar Heroes. I don't know. I haven't had a chance to go back and play it yet. That game rules. I was actually listening to the Gunstar Heroes soundtrack today. The reissue of it. From, I don't know, sometime in the OOs. There's actually a vinyl version of the Gunstar Heroes soundtrack that came out. Like a year ago? Maybe 2 years ago? It's like a best of, because that soundtrack, you know, there's a lot of tracks. I forget the company's name. But that's pretty cool. The person behind those soundtracks was on Back in My Play, which hasn't had a new episode. They have a really good episode about Gunstar Heroes. Actually, so does Retronauts. Steph, I think you missed it last night. I went into, I went back into Dragon's Dogma, and I was, I beat the double Gore Cyclops room. It took a while, but, once you clear out everything else that's in the room, there's three Hellhounds that show up who are really, annoying. They're easy. Once you get to them, they're easy to take them down, but they're very annoying because they jump away a lot. And there's what else is in those rooms? There was a couple corrupted pawns that you gotta kill, or they'll just keep giving you these area of effect spells that just really that wreck you. And then the two Gore Cyclopses. And they went down eventually. They're hard to get. The first couple of health bars are really hard to get down. But then, once you get them down to, like, two or three health bars, they go down pretty quick. This should be the last. This should be it to get her level up. And yes. Okay. She's 26 to get to the next level. Okay, with the money you get from killing these monsters, buy a hunting armor for Rees, and buy two or three monomates if you get spell. Okay. Hit it again to go back to full screen. That's really annoying. Alright, so it saved. Alright, so, hour and a half? Yeah, hour and a half. So we're starting to get through, Phantasy Star here. We got, you know, a ways to go. Even to get out of the first generation. So this game, you play three generations of people. And you play as different people depending on who you decide to marry. And then you play as their descendants. Which, when this came out, was super cool. I was way into that. And, yeah, so we'll be playing this on Tuesday nights from now on, and I'll probably play, you know, at different points during the week to keep playing. So tomorrow night, we're going to be in this collection again for Streets of Rage. We'll play the first Streets of Rage at least. Now we'll come back to the other two. Streets of Rage 2 is my favorite, but we'll play the first one for a while at 8 p.m. They're actually, PSENG is turning off our power here tomorrow to do some work. They have to, I think they're doing some kind of upgrades. So it should be back though by 8. They said 8:30 in the morning till 3 p.m. approximately. So, yeah, everything should be fine by then. And, Thursday night we'll be doing Final Fantasy IX. So, as always, for people watching this in the future, DraftFeels.net is the place for the podcast. DraftFeels Pod on Twitch, Twitter, and Facebook. And check all that stuff out. Check out and Patreon too, patreon.com/draftfeelspod. And soon check out our Extra Life page, which it might be extralife.com/draftfeelspod. I didn't get a chance to, I think that's what I set it up for, but I haven't really had a chance to play. I set it up, but I didn't really get a chance to play around with it too much. And what I think I'm going to do is what most people do, is make a tiny URL for it. And we'll start talking about what we're going to do for Extra Life in November. The basic idea is going to be $10 donations get you an hour of streaming request, which is how you know, a bunch of people seem to do it. And I'm open to playing more or less anything on that day, November, whatever the day in November is. I forget off the top of my head. And so hopefully we get a nice wide variety of games and we can do some cool streams that day. And then if that's successful, my goal is to get to $100 for that. So 10 hours of streaming. We'll be donating that to the Children's Hospital of Philadelphia, which I have a bit of a history about. I have a bit of a history with in the past. And if that's successful, you know, we'll keep doing that. And I've got some other ideas for places we can raise some money for. I think it's a really cool idea. So, all right. Thank you for dropping by, everyone who did. And tomorrow night we'll be streaming Streets of Rage at about 8 p.m.-ish, plus or minus, as always. So, all right. Talk soon.